to burn, ignite the fire in me. A simple lesson never learned leads to tragedy.
All right, this is the first podcast. I'm going to try to do this shit. All right, well, then it's going to be a test, basically, so...
Rehearsal podcast.
Yeah, feel free. We could do this shit live, too. You know, there's a way to do it, so it goes through YouTube, and It's actually live, and people could actually respond in time, in real time with us. But we're not there yet.
Yeah, we have to get better at it.
Yeah, we're not there yet. Yeah. So anyway, that's the future. So anyway, we're here to talk about the band Underhander and some of our history here in LA. Kim and I living here and playing in different bands and stuff like that. And we're here for this. This is the band Underhander. We recorded this with Billy.
Persona non grata.
Yeah, exactly.
Name of the album.
And the creepy old white dude on the back. See that?
That's creepy white dude.
The glass of wine.
Can't do without the creepy white dude.
But this is available everywhere, all platforms, fucking Spotify, all over the place, all around the world. So check it out.
All digital platforms.
Exactly. All digital platforms.
It's hard to say. Digital platform.
Yes, you got it. And then, so yeah, we're just here to talk about that. Talk about living in LA.
Smoking weed. For many years.
For many years. Many years.
Since. Since the late 80s for me. I lived here in fucking 87.
Damn.
From Texas.
Wow, man. Yeah, you're here.
It was a pretty good music scene in Texas, but. You know. I needed to get out of Texas.
So it's kind of safe to say we both kind of split the South.
Get the hell out of the South. Although, you know, Austin's pretty cool. You know, it's a pretty
Austin's pretty cool music city.
Cool spot, man.
Yeah, some other cities there. It's just tough, man. So we found a little bit more freedom out here, a little bit more freedom of expression, it seems like, right? A little bit more acceptance.
And Yeah. When I first got out here, it was like, you know, the metal scene. It was like the hair metal bands were here when I got here.
So like Sunset Strip and all that.
Sunset Strip was all the spandex and teased hair and...
Holy shit. Teased hair, he said.
You remember that stuff? You yeah, remember those here. Bands?
Yeah, I was in some of those bands. I never teased my hair though, man.
So I didn't fit in with those bands. I couldn't tease my hair, man.
Kim had dreads.
Yeah. Back in the day, man. I used to have those dreads.
And then you were in... what was the biggest band back then you were in? Was it that Carnival of Souls? Or?
Yeah. I mean, for the time, we were just kind of, you know, we were just a local band. The thing was, is because we, you know, all the guys in the band were like they're from LA. So all of their friends and stuff would all come to the shows and stuff. That's why there were so many people there.
Right.
And, you know, that was the cool thing about that band. I was the only guy from, you know, out of town. But, you know, went to all their friends from high school and junior high and they'd all come to the shows. And that's why our shows would be so packed.
There was always people at the shows.
Yeah, those guys were all LA guys, the bass player, the guitarist.
I think it was like me and Wine went and saw you guys that time, I think.
Yeah.
I think Club Lingerie, or was it Club Lingerie, or one of those right there off of Vine and Sunset or Hollywood, one of those two.
I mean, we fucking played at Al's Bar. Remember Al's Bar?
Al's Bar, yeah.
Like, you know, that was like the famous downtown.
I think it's a hotel now or something, right?
I don't know. Yeah, it probably is.
You know who lives there? It's that dude that works at the art company, fucking Jesse. The old dude, Jesse. He lives above Al's Bar.
The guy with the slick back hair?
Yeah. This dude, we should give him a shout out.
That dude's got a band, right?
Yeah, what's his band's name? Fucking, I got
I
their
know,
CD.
They're pretty good. They're actually pretty good.
He gave
they
me
play reggae, right?
Yeah, they play reggae. He gave me their CD to put it up because he doesn't know how to fucking do anything on the internet. So I put it up for him on YouTube. Fuck, Jesse. Yeah, I can't remember the name of his band. It's like something Kings or something. The Reggae Kings or Gold Kings or something. No?
I don't remember. I just remember you sent me like a link to his band or something.
I probably got it on my computer here, but I don't want to fuck this up right now. What was that band I sent you the text to the other day? Fucking Spade Ghetto Destruction.
Oh, yeah.
Those guys. Those are badass.
Didn't we play with those guys?
I didn't play. No, I played with Super Slave. It was a different band. Super Slave.
No, I mean, I played on...
You played with them?
No, not with them, but I played... My band...
I think that band... I think that's the time I saw them. They might have opened or y'all opened for them or something.
Yeah.
Yep.
That was, yeah.
That's totally right. It was at that, I think it was at that same fucking show, man.
And those guys were fucking badass.
Or maybe, yeah, you guys played and then they played? Because weren't you down there watching them with us? Or I don't remember.
I don't remember if they came on. I don't remember if they came on before us or after us. But I remember we played the same, that same night.
Yeah, that was dope, man. Yeah, they were a badass band. Fucking.
And it was like 1990-something.
Yeah, it was back in the day. '90s. There's a lot of bands, man, that didn't. Their shit's out on YouTube. You can find their shit on YouTube. But there's a lot of other bands that they never even got their shit out at all, you know?
Yeah.
Fucking, even Juan's band, Slingshot, the punk band. Dude, Tom.
Slingshot?
Yeah.
Slingshot.
With,
Dude, we freaking saw, remember we saw fucking, can we swear on these podcasts?
I think so, yeah. We can beep it out if we can't. I gotta look it up. I think we can. I'm pretty sure we can.
I mean, Joe Rogan, he swears.
Was he just
on
swearing
his?
Just now? Yeah.
I mean,
we got Joe Rogan on the monitor over there, you guys. This is the studios up in the hills of LA somewhere, undisclosed location.
I'm just swearing like a.
Yeah, you can swear. What are you gonna say?
I forgot. Oh, we saw like freaking Black Eyed Peas, remember?
Oh, before, yeah. We saw Black Eyed Peas before they were even anything.
Before they got signed, they were like playing this little club we used Moguls. To work at.
Yep.
In Hollywood. Another one of the many Hollywood stories.
Oh, yeah. There's the Moguls. There's a bunch of Mogul stories. Man, oh, my God.
Chili Peppers.
Chili Peppers. Helmet.
God damn.
Fucking Porno For Pyros.
Porno For Pyros. All those bands Peppers, came through there. We were working there.
Oh, fucking... what was that one band from Colorado? The fucking... They have all the lights and shit. I don't even really like them that much. They're just kind of spacey. Fucking, what's the name of that band? I forget, but they're all spacey and they have a bunch of lights.
Oh, man. Moguls.
And who else... Yeah, there's a lot of cool bands there, man. I had to chase.
I was doing some crazy ass shit back then, man.
Yeah, those are crazy days. This gets it goes way back, man. I mean, like we made it through, man. We survived.
I was like, yeah. That's the key word.
I mean, a lot of people didn't, man. The dude.
Yeah,
there's a lot of people didn't. The dude from Slingshot.
The guy from Slingshot. Yeah. We're just talking about.
He got ran over, man. That didn't. I'm trying. You know what? Juan's actually getting out. I'm getting Juan to get those tapes out, and he's going to digitize them.
Slingshot?
Yeah.
Still has them?
Yeah, he says he's got them, so I'm trying to get him to do that so we can digitize that album and then post it up on YouTube or something, you know?
Sweet.
And then Gary from fucking the X-Idols.
Gary, that guy.
I smoked that with him a few times over at Juan's, though.
Probably did, yeah.
I did, yeah. That was a cool band called the X-Idols. You get a chance, Google them. Their album's out there. But he passed on, I think, after the album was released. I don't know how long after, but that was a really sad story, man. But he had kids, too, man. He had kids and everything, just like Tom. Yeah. So, yeah, man, some of those guys didn't make it.
Remember Space?
Space. Space was badass, dude. Space was like the Grateful Dead of West LA. Yeah, they were like the Grateful Dead of LA.
Those guys were some trippy dudes.
Yeah, fucking Alexis.
One of a kind fellow. Yeah, I never meet anybody else that like Alexis. Was cool.
Shit, man, Alexis was a trip, man. There's a lot of adventures with that dude. Remember the show we did up in that canyon that time off the PCH?
Oh yeah,
some fucking. I think they just. I don't know how that went.
I don't know how we managed to get that show.
I think we just kind of stole the area for a little while or something. Like just barged in. And they had a party, right? And they had, like, generators. They had electricity. They had everything, man. And I don't think we were supposed to be there. I'm not sure exactly who got us in there or whatever, but it was a cool show, you know?
Well, shit. Did we even have a name for that band?
We just kind of jammed, right? Did we just kind of jam?
Yeah.
It was like a jam band, but it was, I don't know. It was cool, but it was a trip.
That was crazy.
And then,
I don't know. Remember, I was the bass player in that band.
You were the bass player.
It was fun.
What was I? So I was guitar, right?
Alexis was the singer.
Who was on the drums?
That young kid. Young kid.
Not that white dude, Paul, no? The business dude, Paul, no?
He was there at first.
Some young kid?
Some young guy. Forgot his name.
Damn, I usually remember all the drummers. Not Mike. Remember Mike Steele? The drummer? Mike. Big time white dude.
I don't remember Mike.
Yeah, he's a funny dude, man. Man, there's all these characters.
Played with so many people.
Holy shit. Wow. Wow, you know what?
But.
I just had a flashback, dude.
But.
I had a dream last night about someone mentioned Sponto.
Oh man, it's
just macho. It just came back to me, and I just realized it was like they were kind of telling me, you know Sponto, right? And I'm like, yeah, I know Sponto. And then they were walking down the hall like they were letting me in this area to go see somebody, and I had to know Sponto to get in.
That was your dream?
That was my dream. I just realized that. Because wow. someone someone of authority asked me, you know Sponto? Yeah, I know Sponto. Yeah. And then they let me in, and it was like this hallway, and I went walking down the hallway, and that was it. That's crazy.
That's another guy that's Sponto. Gone.
Sponto, man. Yeah, Sponto was a shit, man.
Sponto, yeah.
Whew. Sponto had been around for a long time in Venice, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, we should definitely check.
Probably
we
partying should... back there back in the 60s, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah. I think Sponto was around. He had a gallery, Sponto Gallery in Venice.
He was hanging out with Dennis Hopper and shit back in the 60s, I'm sure.
Yep, Sponto was... He went out partying, though, man. He should have slowed down, man. That dude,
yeah,
I think...
Yeah, he partied till the end,
I'm pretty sure this motherfucker... He was older than us at the time. He must have been like 60-something.
Yeah, he was way older than us.
Dude, he told me...
Way older, but he was definitely older than us.
Dude, he told me stories about banging these chicks and then about, like, doing cocaine and all this shit. Like the full-on... Like, at the time that he was old, not, like, back in the day, you know? Like, so I think he was, like... That's why he had a heart attack, okay?
Dang.
But, you know, we love Sponto, man. But, yeah. I think he just partied a little too hard, you know.
Party.
I don't know, man. I should probably roll another one. And then, Kim and I went and saw Mr. Bungle the other night, right?
Mr. Bungle, man. That was fucking...
Let's talk about Mr. Bungle. I'm going to roll this joint while we talk about Mr. Motherfucking Bungle.
I was amazed at the freaking when the freaking mosh pit broke out.
caught us all
by surprise.
Yeah, fucking some kids spilled half my fucking drink.
Spilled his drink. I spilled some of my beer.
You did?
Yeah.
Fucker.
Fucking mosh pit came out of nowhere.
It was typical too, man. It was like it was just unabashed, just like, blah. Just like blah. Your whole body goes flying, and they're like, blah. It's like in slow motion for like half a second.
I was thinking about the days when I used to be in those mosh pits.
I don't know what I was thinking. Yeah, I used to do that. I almost got in the mood the other night.
Man.
When we went to see Mr. Bungle, moment, dude, toward the end. I was like, you know what? Maybe I'll jump in this motherfucker. But then I talked myself out of it. Nah, I fucking came to my senses.
Now, that was a badass fucking Dave Lombardo was on the drums, and Scott, not Ian, was playing the guitar from...
What can you say about it?
And that was just... It was just a Mr. Bungle all-star... all-star band.
All-star jam band.
Of course, of Mr. Mike Patton on the vocals.
Vocals. It was amazing.
He had his hair all braided, and they were all sticking out. And when he first came out, he had like a dog in his... They came out and they were singing, what, the Mr. Rogers Neighborhood.
Oh, yeah, Mr. Rogers.
The Mr. Rogers Neighborhood. And he comes out, and his hair is all braided, and it's all sticking out and shit. He's got this dog in his hand. The dog has on sunglasses, and he's singing Mr.
Rogers. Oh,
he had
a dog in his hand. Yep. All right. I mean, I kind of didn't know. I didn't know if it was a doll or it was a real dog.
I think it was a dog. It seemed like it was moving around.
All right. I mean, my eyes are getting bad.
You didn't see that dog?
I knew he had something in his hand. I thought it was a doll. I didn't know it was moving, though. I couldn't see it moving, no.
The dog had sunglasses on. You got to get some glasses,
I know.
Man.
I had glasses, too. They're just kind of blurry, man.
You make me think I didn't see what I thought. I'm pretty sure I saw a dog.
Well, I actually took some mushrooms, so I was the one on mushrooms, so maybe I just...
Right. You're probably seeing stuff. So, yeah, that's how it started, and they came out, and they rocked out for a couple hours, hour and a half.
Yeah, it was amazing.
And, I was glad I went, and it was...
It was like $80 a ticket, man, for us, which was a good... We saw other tickets that were like 100, 120, 300, but, I mean, I don't know. They did, they went through the set, but then the cool part was when they got to, Stormtroopers of Death, they did a song by SOD.
Oh, yeah.
And the song was originally entitled Speak English or Die. And we're all sitting there wondering, what the fuck is this motherfucker going to say? And, of course, Mike Patton, true to who Mike Patton is, comes out and goes, Speak Spanish or die. So that was badass. So that also shows you, you know, like where the fucking, you know, it's like you can count on music, man. You know, I feel like I can count on, like, music's always been there. You know, it's like that's the one thing. It's kind of, you know. Seems like they got more moral guidance than the motherfuckers running the world, you know?
Yeah. Like, yeah, and it's good when they, like, just step up. I mean, they have an opinion like that. And
that's cool, man.
Step up and, you know, speak it.
Yeah.
Don't die to just speak.
Mike Patton speaks.
Speak whatever you feel.
Homie speaks fluent Spanish. I've heard him speak this. Oh. And he sings, you know,
in
Spanish. So he kills it, man. You know, so that's pretty cool.
Yeah, that's cool. Mike Patton, he's in all those bands, man.
Yep. what's this shit called? Wicked. No, Wedding Cake. Wedding Cake. Yeah. Shout out to Wedding Cake, created Wedding Cake and grew it and everything. Takes that. And so what were we talking about? Where were we?
Mike Patton.
Oh, yeah, Mr. Bungle. I don't know what else to say about
it. We're talking about going and seeing Faith No More and
those
guys next month. Or in May.
Yep, Faith No More, System of a Down, and Korn. It's going to be playing some stadium here, right? So that'll be cool. I'm going to go check that out. We got to start seeing these shows, man, because, you know, a lot of these bands, they're not going to be around or they're going to break up. You know, it's like System of a Down was out for a while. And so the dude in Korn did the Jesus thing for a little while and then came back. And he's back, though, right? I think that dude.
I guess so, yeah.
I think that dude's back. But yeah, man, I don't know. Mr. Bungle was badass. Should we continue on that a little bit? Let's see. What else was there with Mr. Bungle? We ran into this dude, Eric, we've known for a few years. I know you've met Eric before. That dude that we ran into at the very end.
At the show?
Yep. Is this cat? I've known that dude probably longer than I've known you, actually, because when I first moved out here, I started working at a video store in the Valley. And this dude was there. Me and this dude worked together in this video store. And he actually, I think he became a manager or something. And we had like a little falling out, but it was all cool. And then, we're still friends. But I knew him, I think, even before I ran into you and Juan over the hill, man, because I was still in Van Nuys, man. That's how far that goes.
Damn.
Like, he might have known Jeff. Before I knew Jeff. Yeah, he knows Jeff really well. Him and Jeff are real good friends.
Tell the people who Jeff is.
Huh?
Tell the people who Jeff is.
Jeff's a drummer. Jeff's a drummer. I used to be in a band with him. We all used to be in a band with Jeff. I think you were in a we played with him. He was in a band with me back in New Orleans, and then he actually helped me move out here. Actually, he was he had already been out here. He came to New Orleans to play in this band I was in. All of us knuckleheads decided to come out here. Only me and Jeff stayed out here in L.A., and the other two knuckleheads went back home crying their mamas. And me and Jeff are still out here today. Jeff was here anyway. So that's who Jeff is, man. And then we started playing in a band, I think, with Jeff on some different stuff. Or maybe not live, but we did some studio stuff.
Yeah, I played with Jeff a few times, yeah.
And then his bands have played with our bands.
Our
band Underhander
a lot of times
has opened up with Jeff and his band was called
Two Fist
and
Two Fist?
There's another one, 65 Gallows, I think it is.
Yeah,
and then there's another one. He's been in a bunch of bands, man, around LA, and he's out right now. He was actually somehow working with the Tool show, dude. So I think he was
really?
Actually, yeah, he's somehow working with the Tool show now and then.
He does on tour with him, or just
doing something. Stuff. I think he's doing some kind of. I think he's selling. I'm not sure, man. I think he's doing merch, but I'm not sure. I'm not sure. I think he's with the tour, but I'm not sure. But
nice.
And hey, by the way, did I call you? Why didn't you go with me to the Tool show that time?
Oh,
you couldn't, right? Because I asked you.
I couldn't go.
This motherfucker couldn't go to the Tool show. Let me tell you, the Tool show, that was the show, man. Fucking, you like Tool, right?
Hell yeah.
You love Tool. The fuck? How do you turn down? He turned down box seats to fucking Tool.
I didn't know it was box seats.
We were inside a glass case with a fridge, a couch, 7 personal seats behind a glass.
Missed out.
Looking right down on Danny Carey. Yeah. And he was just like, it was like he was a fucking octopus, man. You should have seen it, dude. He was just crazy, man. And then Derek, our friend Derek, got to go.
Derek.
That's a story, dude. Derek.
I invited Derek over recently to come watch the Super Bowl with me. Derek being Derek, he showed up like the last play of the game.
Right.
Derek's finally knocking at the door. Hey, I'm here. Derek, you missed the whole game, man. I guess he Yeah, he had other things to do.
Derek's a funny motherfucker, dude. But that show was crazy. Derek got to go. It was funny when we walked in. It was me and Derek, like two brown dudes. And then everyone else in there is white. And it's these, you know, these secure, exclusive seats. And so, you know, we start explaining ourselves, like for whatever reason. And then the dudes in there would start explaining themselves. They were like, so like no one that was there actually were the original owners of the tickets. They had all been given off to friends, which is how we got the tickets. So that's, I don't know what that means, but that's fucking hilarious, dude. Everybody fucking, I think that's how people survive in LA, you know?
Right?
That was creepy, man.
That was wild, man. That came out of nowhere.
Yeah, that's just.
Expect that to happen. I mean, you know. Obviously, because he's still like young and has his whole life still ahead of him. When he's, you know,
in a helicopter crash.
And the, oh man, of all things, a helicopter crash.
I mean, that's just horrifying, man.
Yeah, man.
It's just
terrifying, and it's really hard to believe that it actually happened. You still, you know, still think about it a lot. You're like, wow, that actually happened. He fucking got killed in a helicopter crash.
I'm not even a huge fan of the dude, but I've lived for the past 20 something years in LA with his story in the background of my mind and stuff. And
been here for 20 plus years.
And so
I've grown up right in front of us from the time when he was 17, when he first started playing here with the Lakers. And
I felt terrible, man, for, you know, a while, you know, for like really bad. Like I felt, it just creeped me out too, the way it happened with his daughter and everything. It's just like, it just creeped me out, man.
About his daughter being on the helicopter too, and then all those other people too.
Yeah, just all the families and the kids. It was like moms and dads. It was just like, geez, man. It was just like moms, dads, kids, and
if it happened like that, you know, all things.
So that's why we're doing this podcast as well, is to do some shit we never did before, because you never know when you're not going to be here to do it ever, you know. So
yeah,
to start documenting some shit, but. Yeah, man, that's a big loss, man, how Kobe went out like that. It still haunts me when I see them. There's lots of murals everywhere, all over the city.
They're all everywhere. I've seen people, like, you know, painting murals ever since that whole thing's been going up, watching murals be painted and, you know, seeing them after they've been finished. And it's crazy. They're all over the place.
Yeah. And it's like, people stopping, taking pictures. It's sad, man. You know, you think about it. You know, it's just, I don't know, it just creeps me out, man. It's just like I haven't had anything creep me out like that in a while, man. Like, I think it's though because it's the helicopter, man. That just, like, it's like,
yeah, I think about helicopter and explosion, fog, and they had a fog and crashing to the side of a freaking mountain and stuff. No, man, that's just not a good way to go. I mean, there is a good way to go.
No, that's definitely not one. You know, that's, especially that age, you know, he's that young and he's got it made. He made it past the finish line of life, you know, all the challenges and shit. And then, you know, I'm sure he's going to have more challenges in life, but geez, you know, just to get taken out like that is just fucking terrible.
Everybody's going to have those masks on.
We're all going to have masks. I'll wear the fucking mask.
Nobody's gonna want to fucking shake hands or anything.
I'll wear the mask. If I have to wear the mask, I'll wear the fucking mask, dude. I mean, fuck. I mean, I guess, right? What are you gonna do? What if they tell you gotta wear the mask?
Yeah, well, I guess you gotta wear the fucking mask,
fool.
Wear the damn mask.
See, that's what this is kind of about,
go out,
right?
And vote.
Persona non grata. Vote. Vote.
Vote for the man on the back of the freaking. He's gonna be running shit
forever.
You don't fucking go out and vote.
With his fingers crossed, with his hand over his heart, and all that bullshit.
But give the album a listen. It was produced by Billy Graziati from Biohazard and Power Flow. And you'll be surprised at the guy that plays that type of music. Even be interested in producing a band like ours, but he was, and he gave a lot of good insight.
Yeah,
and
a lot of good stuff.
He did a great job.
made me sing
a lot of stuff,
a lot of
man.
Shit over and over and over again.
Over and over and over again. Yeah. Be like,
I think
hey, man, that's good. I know you can do better.
Yeah.
Come on, man, let's do it again.
But yeah, it came out good. I'm totally proud of it. It's all over the internet. There's a couple of videos out. We gotta get a new video going soon, man. I don't know. We're gonna figure something out and put together some kind of fucking low budget, fucking no budget video. If anybody hears the album and hears a good idea, send us an email or something. I don't know if this makes it out. To Live and Die in LA, Underhander. Peace.
Yeah.
All right. Good night. See ya.
Accompanied by sirens for a pathway.